Welcome to the co-sponsored virtual organ concert, a first for both Gene Hunsler, the organist representing the American Guild of Organists Binghamton chapter, and Binghamton United Presbyterian Church. I am Rebecca Mebert, coordinator and keyboard accompanist for this congregation. When the concert was scheduled months ago, the hope was that we would be able to have people here in the sanctuary, social distanced and masked, to hear Gene play. We moved into this format a couple of months ago and have been planning towards the time of this beautiful music created by Gene Hunsler on the Gibraltarian Sanctuary organ. This journey of music entitled An Evening in Paris celebrates the completion of a multi-year process of re-leathering the four manuals of our sanctuary organ. Organs are an amazing creation of carefully planned and designed columns and placements of metal and wood pipes, with electric wires and leather being important connectors, as well as the bellows to push air through the pipes, all things needed to create the sounds that you will be hearing. This organ was completed in 1996-97. It was a replacement of the previous organ whose bellows were located in the basement, considered problematic after a small fire in the basement had damaged the bellows. It was decided to have all the components of the next organ in the sanctuary level. The modular console was an original design by Gibraltarian Organ Company, specifically for our sanctuary. In order to avoid the need for scaffolding to install it, it was considered important to have it modular. It was carried up in pieces and reassembled in our balcony, the console being the key to the operations in the chamber above and beyond me. Of note, this may be the last of the style created by the builder, as he died young, leaving a family behind. Organs are like living beings in some ways. They breathe, they need taking care of with tuning and keeping temperature appropriate. Eventually, replacement parts are needed. Leather, like human skin, dries out and sometimes breaks, so it is important to plan the re-leathering in a timely way to keep the instrument functioning. Money given by several donors in the past and designated for the organ and music program have been used to help us complete this project this summer, an 8-year project. We honor and thank them for their gifts. Merchant and Sons of Syracuse, New York has been the continuity of workmanship and tuning over the years. Important stakeholders in this organ were the late Jonathan Biggers, head of the organ department at Binghamton University, and both artist in resident and organ consultant on the project for this creation of this organ. The late Dr. Vern Lubes, choir member and a music lover, chaired the fundraising committee for the sanctuary organ. Two staff members engaged in this project were Robin Lostetter, director of music, and the Reverend Dr. Art Suggs, pastor. Our current pastor, the Reverend Kimberly Chastain, kept the vision and supported the work of the organ and the resources for this concert today. We thank all of the people who are making this possible, including our recording sound technician, David Williams, Andy Chadwick, church member and member of the local chapter of the AGO, and an organist pianist in his own right. And now I introduce you to John Holt, dean of the local chapter of the AGO and a faithful listener for hours of Gene's practicing. It takes many people to make this concert happen. We can't wait to hear you, Gene, brave explorer of the virtual world.
Gene Herman Hunsler is an Endwell, New York native. She received a Bachelor of Music degree in organ performance from Oberlin Conservatory of Music in Oberlin, Ohio, and a master's degree in piano performance from Ithaca College School of Music in Ithaca, New York. She also had additional studies in organ with Dr. Jonathan Biggers and Mark Laubach. She was an instructor of music at the Broome Community College, which is now called SUNY Broome, until moving to Germany, where for 18 years she taught piano, performed extensively throughout Europe, as soloist, chamber musician, and accompanist. She has served numerous churches as organist and choir director and has been a longtime singer in and accompanist of the Madrigal Choir of Binghamton. She is currently sub-dean of the Binghamton AGO chapter. Our thanks go to the staff of the United Presbyterian Church who provided administrative and technical assistance in producing this presentation. Jean's performance tonight is called An Evening in Paris. We'll now let Jean take us to Paris.
Thank you. pull up a chair, don your beret, and pour yourself a glass of wine. Welcome to Paris, without the risks of flying. The music on today's recital is representative of the long and rich tradition of French organ music, culminating in the late 19th and early 20th centuries in the organ lofts of Paris. Thanks to mechanical improvements and colorful new tonal possibilities, the French Romantic symphonic organ was born. An impressive lineage of teachers and students at the Paris Conservatory playing on spectacular pipe organs, many by the firm Cavaille Cole, have left us a wealth of organ literature. Eugène Gigoux, organist at Saint Augustin, wrote the Grand Coeur Dialogue, which showcases glorious fanfare trumpets in alternation with the full organ. Certainly an appropriate opening for an evening in Paris. The prayer, Allegretto, and Prelude were written by brothers René and Louis Verne for organ or harmonium, a reed organ which gained popularity in the late 19th century. René, who was organist at Notre Dame des Champs, died tragically at age 40 in the 1918 Second Battle of the Marne. His older brother, the almost blind Louis, was organist at Notre Dame for 37 years and was a prolific composer of organ music, including six massive organ symphonies. The charming pieces on today's program are reminiscent of Parisian street musicians, accordions, and carousels.
Thank you.
Belgian César Franck is, so to speak, the granddaddy of generations of famous organists, having been professor of organ in the Paris Conservatory and organist at Saint-Clotilde in the mid-1800s. Louis Vierne was one of his students. The dramatic chorale in B minor, written shortly before his death in 1890, is the second in a set of three such chorales, generally regarded as his masterpieces. A haunting melody first heard in the bass, and thereafter appearing in various guises, forms the basis of the entire piece. The second theme, chorale-like in nature, is first heard alone, and then later combined with the first melody. After a middle fantasy, fugal treatment, and a final triumphant appearance of the theme, the work ends on a peaceful note.
Thank you.
Even Parisians need to escape the city now and then. So also we. Off to Italy and England. The Gigue by Marco Enrico Bossi was originally scored for flute and orchestra. Transcribed by his son Renzo, this joyous romp around the keyboards precedes two utterly charming pieces, Folk Tune and Scherzo, by Englishman Percy Whitlock.
Thank you.
We return to Paris and the Basilica Sacré-Cœur, where Henri Moulet's father was choir master and his mother played the harmonium. Moulet studied at the Paris Conservatory with Charles-Marie Vidor, composer of the well-known toccata from the Fifth Symphony. Tu es Petra is typical of the genre French toccata. Enough said.
Thank you.
On a lighter note, we end our European journey literally dancing out of the church. Derek Bourgeois, French name, English composer, wrote the serenade as a recessional for his own wedding. Quotation, not wishing to allow the guests the luxury of proceeding in an orderly 2-4 meter, I wrote it in 11-8, and in case anyone felt too comfortable, I changed it to 13-8 in the middle. The piece was dedicated to his wife, named Jean. Au revoir et bonsoir.